Monday Night Yin. We'll get started tonight with whatever you have that's this size. So whether that's a blanket folded or maybe it's a pillow, something like this. So you want it to be fairly low to the ground, not anything too high. And you'll bring it toward the top of the mat or wherever you're laying. You don't even need a mat, really. You're going to put your feet on it. And you're going to lie down onto your back with the feet propped up on whatever you're using. And it's like Shavasana with the feet propped up just a little bit. Arms come out by the sides. Eyes start to close. Then start to take a deep breath in through the nose. And start to take a long exhale out through the mouth or out through the nose. Sometimes when you go out through the mouth, it's a nice cleansing way to sort of let go of the whole day. And we'll do a couple more like that. Take a deeper breath in through the nose, filling all the way up. And exhale out of the mouth, let it go. Last one, breathe in deeply. Slowly exhale however you want. And you'll start to soften the breath, just going back and forth. Starting to slow down and coming into some stillness. Notice what's taking up space in the mind, how you're landing on your mat, how you're feeling. And then maybe checking in with yourself once or twice throughout the class to see how that shifts and changes. So we'll keep moving the blanket. You'll start to bring yourself up. You can use the forearms to come up, and you're shifting the blanket or whatever you're using to right behind the knees. And then you're coming right back down again. Lie down flat. The feet can roll out. So everything we're doing in yin is passive. We're not looking for straight lines. We're looking for an ease. Just allowing the body to be in these poses. You're coming into a place in our day where we don't have to pay attention anymore. Can just lie there. I'll tell you what to do when it's time to move to the next thing. So that you can enjoy slowing things down. Coming into a different pace. Start to make your way up. You can use the forearms, you can roll over to one side. Whatever's easy, go slow. This time, the blanket's gonna move to the back of the hips. So you'll lie down onto the mat, walk the feet in, lift the hips up, and just move the blanket. So it's underneath the hips, probably the lower back too. Arms out by the sides, and you can start to walk the legs forward. If this feels like too much of a back bend, then bring the legs in and keep the feet underneath the knees. That's an option too. So it's like a supported bridge, or if it feels okay to extend the legs out in front of you, do that. So see which one's best for right now. Stay there. And notice how the body and the energy is shifting just by moving the blanket. You're still laying down flat on the mat, but we're changing where the blanket's supporting you. Underneath the feet, it's pretty relaxing. Same with the knees. But as we start to move up the spine, you're coming into a little bit more of a back bend, which presents a little bit more energy. If you haven't already, bring the soles of the feet to the mat. Roll over onto one side. Come up to seated. And this time we're moving the blanket so that it's underneath the shoulder blades, so the upper back. But you want the tops of the shoulders to come down onto the mat. So the head's on the ground. Arms are out to the side like a T shape is probably good. You can stay with the feet on the mat, or you have the option to extend the legs out in front of you. So arms shouldn't be, if they're out to the sides like a T shape, they shouldn't be on whatever prop you're using underneath you. That's a good way to find the right position here. And as you let the chest just spread and lift open, notice how this shape feels. Start to walk the feet in. They're not already there. Roll over onto one side very slowly. Then you'll use the hands to bring yourself up enough. Now the blanket or pillow goes underneath the head. You'll come back down, lying with the support underneath the head. Legs down by the out in front of you, arms down by the sides. Keep the eyes closed. Noticing the pace that we're taking. Still lying flat, but just moving the blanket all the way up the body, from the feet all the way to the head. Start to bend the legs. Bring the soles of the feet to the mat. Roll over onto your right side. Take the blanket, put it between the knees. Lying down onto your right side, stretch the arms out in front of you. Now, if you just ate, be careful. We're coming into a twist, so you can take this where you want it to be. If the stomach's upset at all, or if it's very full, maybe you just stay lying on your side. You could put another blanket under the head if you want. Otherwise, reach this left arm up toward the sky. Let it roll open to the left. And you can keep the gaze up toward the ceiling if you want, closing the eyes, or for a deeper twist, start to roll the head over to the left. So taking this twist where it feels good in your body, being mindful of where you're at with digestion. If you have an empty stomach, the full twist will probably feel good, or if it's been an hour or two since you ate, that's probably fine. So twists are good for digestion, but you want to time it right at the same time. You don't want to take space away from the stomach when it's trying to work on the food we put in it. Wherever you are, start to roll back onto your right side. Lie here for a moment. And we'll start to transition over to our left side. Keep the blanket between the knees as you move over to the left side. You come all the way over onto the left side. So the right hand's on top of the left hand. You can start to open up the right arm out to the side. Seeing where the twist lands in your body on this side. And if you feel like the right arm's just kind of hanging out in space, sometimes it's nice to bend at the elbow. Or you can put something underneath the right shoulder if there's a lot of space there, whether that be another blanket or pillow.
Text man.
take a deeper breath in through the nose. And exhale. Roll back onto your left side. Stay here for a couple of breaths. And you'll use the hands to bring yourself up to a seat, hanging onto this blanket or whatever you're using. You'll start to make your way onto hands and knees, and wherever you have your props, I would bring them to the side of the mat. They'll be a little bit more accessible. So come to hands and knees like tabletop. And then we're coming into child's pose, but I recommend wedging the blanket behind the knees for this one. You can bring the big toes together, and then you can sit back onto the blanket. And then a couple options for your child's pose. You could just come down this way with the forehead down on the mat. It's a pretty deep opening across the shoulders and the chest, so see if that feels good. If you want to come into it a little softer, you could bring a pillow, blankets, whatever you have in front of you. It's just barely in front of the knees, depending on the length. The idea is when you come down, you have something to support you. You could turn the head to one side, would probably feel best. Or you could start to work the pillow farther up so it just supports the forehead. And then the nose is free to breathe. So any of those options, maybe you explore all three. So the blanket behind the knees gives the knees a little bit more space to bend. Well, child's pose is a calming pose. Sometimes it can become uncomfortable, and this makes it a little bit more comfortable for a longer hold. Let the belly be soft.
Seems impossible to face when someone else instead of me always seems to know the way. Then I look at you and the world's alright with me. Oh, just from look at you.
Start to bring the hands back in underneath you. Move the pillow in front of you off to the side. Take the blanket. If you're on a pretty hard surface, put the blanket underneath your knees. If you're on a soft surface like carpet, you probably don't need any padding under the knees. But you're going to be on your knees for a little while, which is why I say to do it now. So you'll come back to tabletop. Something underneath your knees if you need it. And then you'll take this right arm, and you'll bring it underneath you coming down onto the side of the face. So we're getting into the shoulder, and we want to keep the hips somewhat over the knees. You can start to stretch that left arm forward, but you can let the elbow relax on the mat. So you're not stretching it all the way forward, but just enough to give you some space. You're putting some weight on this right shoulder to open it up a little bit. Right side of the face is down on the mat. Just rest here. Couple more breaths here. We'll start to slide the left hand back down in front of the face. Start to press into the left hand to come back up onto both hands. Back into tabletop. Notice if there's a difference in one side of the body compared to the other. We'll take our time transitioning over to the other side. Left arm, palm facing up, comes underneath you, right behind the right arm. Let yourself down onto the left side of the face. Level off the hips. Start to slide the right arm forward enough to where you can rest the elbow down on the ground. And then once you find a place where you can stay and the breath stays soft, keep the eyes closed. Just be in the pose. Start to bring the right hand in front of the face. Press yourself up to both hands, coming back into tabletop. Stay here for a couple of breaths. Trying to even out the spine, the shoulders. Staying on hands and knees, you'll step the right foot forward outside of the right hand. So you're coming into what we call a yin dragon. So the hands are down in front of you. Right knee is outside of the right arm. If the hands can come down easily, leave them there. If you need a little bit more support, this is where you could use a chair and bring that toward the top of the mat and step the right foot outside of the chair and then come down onto the forearms and rest here. Some of you might be open enough to come down onto the forearms or to put something in front of the chest, like a pillow or a blanket, and come down onto the forearms. But we'll be here for a little bit. So maybe you start on the hands and you work your way down if that feels good. The left knee, the back knee, you want that way back. So if it helps to tuck the toes and shift the leg back behind you, it'll just give you a little bit more space in the hips. And once you find a place where it feels pretty good in the body, or you can let go of time, close the eyes. It's a pretty deep hip opening. At a certain point, you might be able to just let go. Sometimes stuff starts coming up for people. You just keep coming back to the breath. Last couple breaths. You'll start to make your way up onto your hands if you're not there already. And then you'll bring this right knee back to tabletop. You'll stay in tabletop. And with the hands down in front of you, just move the hips side to side. Start to make your way back to center. And we'll come into the other side. So left foot steps forward. start to shift back that right leg. So maybe you tuck the toes and shift the right knee back, then untuck the toes. Start with the hands down underneath you or the forearms on a chair in front of you on the seat. Or if you feel really open and you want to come down to the forearms right away, you can do that. You can always bring a prop underneath the chest. Close the eyes.
This is walls thinking about our body, what they mean for our salvation. With only the clothes that stand up in, just the ground on which we stand. Is the darkness ours to take?
Last couple breaths. And slowly start to make your way back up onto the hands, or just up from where you were before. The hands down on the mat, bring that left knee back to tabletop. Walk the hands underneath the shoulders. Level off the hips. Start to move the hips side to side. So it's a longer hold, and even though these are passive poses, they're still getting really deep into the body. You have to be feeling this in the hips. We want to take our time transitioning out of longer holds before we jump into the next pose. Letting that soak in a little bit. So you'll come to seated. You'll take the blanket, move it off to the side. Come to seated with the legs out in front of you. And if you're using a blanket, let me show you the shape that we're going for, or pillow. You're gonna bring this right against the lower back the long way, so that if you were to lay back, there's something behind you. You might need to build a taller thing. I already know I need something taller in this pose, so you can start with something lower and then build up from there if you want to. The legs out in front of you. keep the left leg extended out in front of you. Make sure the pillow is all the way up against the lower back. This right leg's gonna bend, and two options with the right leg. Some of you are gonna be able to come up onto the top of the foot, the right foot. Some of you, that's not an option. You just flex the foot and the toes go out to the side. This right knee's pointing straight forward. It can go off to the side a little bit, but not too far off to the right. Another option. Some of you might be finding yourself where you have the leg, but the knee is lifted pretty far away from the mat. If that's you, you put something underneath the knee and let the knee rest on something. Once you have the legs figured out, you start to walk yourself back and lay onto this support that you set up for yourself. And you can keep building up for it. So if you wanted to prop the head up even more, you could grab another pillow and put it underneath the head. Arms just come out by the sides. So you're getting a back bend. We're opening up the knee, the quad, and an internal hip rotation of the hips. Both hips are touching the ground. The right foot's outside of the right hip. Christmas light, clutch the light. Smoke the screen to make you what it was to be. To deepen the breath a little bit. To come out, you'll have to come up onto your forearms first and slowly crawl your way up to your hands, coming back up to seated. And then you'll lean over to the left, extending the right leg forward, nice and slow. Let the legs be side by side for a moment. Sit up tall, close the eyes. Feeling the difference in one leg compared to the other. And you'll blink open the eyes. Start to lean over to the right hip. Bend the left leg, either coming onto the top of the foot. Left foot's outside of the hip. Or remember, you can flex that left foot out to the side. Keep the left knee forward. Notice if the knee's lifted away from the ground. If it is, place something underneath it. You can stay right here if this isn't enough. You feel like lying back onto the pillows and the blankets behind you is a good idea. Come back. Option to lift the head even more if you want to stack something underneath. Stars are leaving, dark to dark. start to take a deeper breath in through the nose. Soft exhale. Make your way up onto your forearms first. Then one hand at a time. Back up to seated. Lean over to the right hip. Extend the left leg out in front of you. Coming back to seated with the legs out in front of you. And the feet can be about hip width distance apart or all the way together if you want. We're just coming into a forward fold, but just let the head come down toward the legs. Don't worry about reaching the feet or anything like that. We're not reaching at all. It's just a heavy forward fold. In fact, turn the palms to face up so you're not reaching for anything. Close the eyes. Just think about this more as a surrender or a bow. Rounding of the spine. Legs are soft. Up to seated. Slowly rolling yourself back up. And you'll bend the legs to one side. You'll take what's behind you and put it in front of you. So right in front of you. Then bring the knees. You want to sit onto the left hip. So bring the knees over to the side. You could even put a blanket between the knees here. If you have an extra blanket, that would be really nice, but if you don't, it's not a big deal. So there's like a 6-inch gap between my hip and the bolster, but you just have to work with the length that you have. So if you need to push it farther away, that's fine. You want to be able to come down and have support. So you're lying down on your side, arms on either side. Start with laying on your left, the left side of the face. Let the body be heavy here. Notice how the neck feels. You have the option to turn the face the other way, bringing a twist into the cervical spine. But what's nice about this is there's still plenty of space for the belly. So if you did just eat, this shouldn't bother you. If you turn the head, turn it back so you're back on the left side of the face. And we'll all use the hands to start walking ourselves back up. And to switch sides, especially if you have something between the legs, it's probably easier to just sit and spin over to the right. Lining up the hip, depending on the length of whatever you're using. Then start to walk yourself down with the hands. Start with the right side of the face on the pillows and blankets. And start to sink into it, letting the body be nice and heavy. Making any adjustments you need right now, still keeping the right side of the face down onto the pillows. Getting the body set up. And then notice the space in the neck. If you did it on the first side, maybe you play with turning the head the other way, coming into that twist. left side of the face is on the pillows. Start to turn the head back to where we started, so the right side of the face is on the pillows. And walk the hands in underneath you, slowly pressing yourself back up to seated, taking the blanket out from between the legs if you're using that. Then you have all these props to use to come into Shavasana. We explored a lot of different ones to start class. You can choose any of those. Maybe avoid the backbend ones. So something underneath the feet, the knees, the head, combination of all three, whatever you think would feel best. Then once you get yourself set up, close the eyes. Maybe you put something over the eyes. Down by the sides. Begin to soften. Coming straight into Shavasana. Bend the legs, bring the soles of the feet to the ground or the pillow if you have something underneath the knees. Take your time. And you'll roll over onto your left side. either cradling the head in the arm, or if you have a pillow underneath the head, you can use that. You'll use the hands to press yourself up to an easy cross-legged seat, whichever direction you're facing. Still keeping the eyes closed. And a moment of this stillness to appreciate where your practice took you tonight. Bring the hands together to seal your practice. Bow the head to honor and acknowledge your heart and spirit, as well as everyone around you. Bring the head back up. Blink open the eyes. Namaste. Thanks, everyone. Hope you sleep well. Take that Shavasana wave and go right to bed, or whatever you're doing with the rest of your evening.